Okay, let's have another crack at how big Graham's number is. Let's start with 3 arrow 3. This is just 3 to the power of 3. Bang, bang, bang. That's 27. The arrow meant this number to this power. Simple enough. Now, how about 3 double arrow 3? When we have a double arrow, we're essentially saying, take this leading number and string it out with single arrows like this, and do it this number of times. So if the second number had been, say, 10, we'd have had 10 threes like this. Luckily, the second number was just a 3, so we have a manageable 3 threes. 3 arrow 3 arrow 3. Now we know what a single arrow means, so 3 to the power of 3 arrow 3. Now we know from a moment ago that 3 arrow 3 was 27, so we have 3 to the 27. Bang, 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 bang. That's about 7.6 trillion. Another way to think about double arrows, which is very helpful, is that you are building a tower of this number of this height. So in our example, a tower of threes, which is 3 high. And here, when you work it out, you go from top to bottom and right to left. A 27 here, 7.6 trillion overall. So there's 3 double arrow 3, a pretty big number. What about 3 triple arrow 3? Well, just like double arrows created a string of single arrows, triple arrows create a string of double arrows. Take the lead number, again 3 in our example, and string it out like this. 3 double arrow 3 double arrow 3 double arrow, etc, etc. Again, if the trailing number had been, say, 10, it would have looked like this, with 10 threes. But again, luckily, the trailing number here was a measly 3, so we only need 3 threes. This is what we're left with. 3 double arrow 3 double arrow 3. Now remember what I said about double arrows representing that power tower? So now we're saying we're towering this number, 3, and the tower is this number high, 3 double arrow 3. Now we already saw that 3 double arrow 3 is actually about 7.6 trillion. So that's our tower height. Imagine that, a tower of threes that is 7.6 trillion digits high. Starting at the very top, working right to left, here we are at the summit. We have 3 to the 3, that's 27. Then down a step, 7.6 trillion now. And now we work all the way down this epic tower, trillions of times. The number getting crazily big with each step down. By the time we get down to base camp, here at the very bottom, we will have created a number so big, it doesn't even bear thinking about. Isn't this arrow notation amazing? Just adding single arrows between the threes took us from 27 to 7.6 trillion to a number that seems beyond comprehension. Now you can probably guess what a monster 3 4 arrow 3 is going to be. This expands to 3 triple arrow 3 triple arrow 3. Now triple arrows mean 3 double arrow followed by this chain. But now the trailing number that tells us what to put here and how long the chain is going to be happens to be 3 triple arrow 3. And we know that number is ridiculous, so this chain is going to be pretty darn long. And knowing what these double arrows mean, we have to start constructing another of these enormous power towers. But this time, the height of our tower is going to be figured out using this beast of a number. So let's see how this plays out. We start here with 3 to the 27. Already a pretty big number. But that just tells us the height of the tower below, how many threes there are here. But this number just tells us the height of another tower of threes below that. And this continues, each whopper of a number simply telling us how many threes there are in the tower below it. You keep building down. And how many layers do you build down? Well, this number, 3, 3 arrow 3, which is unimaginable in itself. So can you imagine how big the final tower of threes must be after we've iterated all the way through this process? Can you imagine that? I think you probably can't. Let's call this monstrosity G1. Is that Graham's number? Nowhere near it. What we do is we now take another pair of threes, and the number of arrows between them is 3, 4 arrow 3, G1. That's not the number of digits here. That's not even the number of powers we're talking about. That is the number of arrows. And we've shown how quickly arrows can blow things up beyond belief. Now, we can't even count the arrows.
Boy, that escalated quickly.
Let's call this new number G2. Now take another pair of threes. How many arrows are we going to put between these ones? You guessed it, G2. This gives us G3. And then we do it again, and we keep repeating the process. The huge number we get becomes the number of arrows in the next number. And you keep doing this 64 times. When you finally finish, there you go. You have Graham's number. This is the upper bound to an answer to a reasonably simple question involving coloured lines between vertices on cubes in higher dimensions. That's explained in another video by Ron Graham himself. Check out the links that are on the screen or in the video description.
But this is such a big number, the 2 to that power and that power are kind of hard to distinguish. It's such a big number.